The markets will come crashing down because the great manipulation won't work indefinitely. This system has been tried many times. What is different this time is that most of the money is tied up in a casino where no one admits who the losers are. So we wait until there are 50% losers, and then the unavailing will commence. The casino owners never lose. You might want to invest your money in an undervalued asset, which is anything but the stock market and real estate. Welcome back to the Atlantis Report. You are here for your daily dose of the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Please take a second to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and don't forget to also hit the notification bell. Thank you. From president to president, the fraud continues in the form of printing trillions of counterfeit dollars, but this fraud must come to an end. And usually, when the stock market hits the stratosphere signal, the end is near. However, the government believes it is the cause of the market going so high, and it will have to take also credit for the crash even though it had nothing to do with it. It was the patsy that happens to be at the printing press visiting when the raid occurred. It would be wise to remember we are in uncharted waters, and this market could reverse on a dime. We should not discount the idea that those in charge might reach a tipping point where they crash the financial system to make a great deal of money. While this may seem outlandish, the possibility is real. This doesn't mean that every rich guy and gal would sign on to this plan, just enough to push things over the edge. When things have gone too far in one direction, history shows that a correction always takes place. There is an interconnections of capital markets. Usually, when one segment of the market gets weak, say, local government budgets or consumer debt, that weakness can be propped up for a time from strength in other sectors. Like corporate financial strength or a debt-free federal government. The different areas can provide some give to prop up that weakness for a while. But what happens when many sectors experience significant weakening at the same time? Where will the help come from next? Mainly when the deep pockets like the US Treasury and the Federal Reserve Bank have shot all their silver bullets. That is the predicament we are in today. Without recourse and with mountains of debt in all sectors. This is a severe and scary time as the debt bubble implodes. Both Rob Kirby and Ellen Brown are now warning that the USA cannot have negative rates because of $500 trillion of interest rate derivatives. Global debt equals $250 trillion, with global assets equaling $360 trillion. Global derivatives equal $1,500 trillion, and they get paid out first. These stupendous figures just glaze the eyes of even educated people, and they have no idea of the potential calamity at hand. The lunatics are in charge of the asylum. We are already a socialist state supported by deficit spending, money printing, and the world's reserve currency, and there is no way out of it now. Until we have mortgaged America to the hilt and borrowed and spent every last penny, the game will not change. But when it does, cataclysmic suffering, US Civil War and ultimately World War. The 100 million socialism has already killed will look like an average week in the future. Bottom line, the world's population is outgrowing the productive capacity to support it, and perhaps in a very horrific way, socialism may actually bring about the cure. The 2009 crisis should have been allowed to play out rather than prolonging it while the big shots guarded themselves. Technically, the collapse will still happen, but only the peons will suffer while the rich are safely in their bunkers and divested. All the nuances of fairness, equality, and freedom disappear when the rich are vulnerable. They bend the rules and place themselves above the law. Quantitative easing was in essence a 10-year timeout for the rich. Typically people have to play through the difficulty but not the oligarchs. We dodged that bullet when the Fed ended the fake liquidity crisis with the repos. If the Fed did not step in, the S&P would be at least 20% down from the end of September, maybe 30%. The removal of liquidity for working capital loans would have caused many payrolls not to be paid, and many invoices to be set aside until they could be paid later. Instant layoffs and a recession by now, only 45 days later. The globalists, Wall Street, and the ECB would have won by forcing the Fed into quantitative easing and zero interest rates. Which, by the way, does not and never has fixed any recession anywhere in the world, ever. Fortunately, they did a faceplant. The Fed kicked their butts badly. Possibly on purpose, perhaps by accident, as this is the first time they have applied economics correctly in my memory. Of course, they will try again, but not until next year. It will take a new plan and a new conspiracy to get the ball rolling. My personal guess is late winter, early spring. The news media will be full of scare stories that tell a new fake narrative. I personally like Bloomberg for reading today's tale. The new plan will be exactly like the old plan in this one crucial respect. It will cause the removal of financial economy liquidity and real economy liquidity. The only way to crash the financial economy is to remove liquidity, forcing prices of assets to fall just to find buyers. If you remove working capital from the economy, you suffocate business almost immediately. Once business shrinks by having the bottom fall out, it takes a long time to rebuild. Stock values have been kept artificially high to make it look on paper as if future pensions are all well covered. But if stocks would today suddenly be valued only for their fair value, like they eventually will, it would become clear for everybody to see, there are no pensions for the next retiring generation. For a long, all have been used for public spending, deep state, government, and pampering of boomers, who are the biggest voting group. You cannot print $4.5 trillion to paper over a financial crisis and not expect a bigger one. My parents told me, money doesn't grow on trees, when I was growing up. Creating money out of thin air and saying it is wealth is the same thing. A lot of business leaders are not stupid and know the truth, as well. This global slowdown will lead to a global meltdown. The US market and its franchise markets around the world are so unstable that a slight decline could be catastrophic. Because of this, the markets are being propped up daily by massive monetary operations. Over $100 billion per night in short-term repos. This money is being rolled over, not new money, plus over $60 billion in monthly quantitative easings. This is newly printed money. Without this recent Fed market operation, the markets would have collapsed massively over the past 30 days. The dollar has crossed the Rubicon and is now in the hyperbolic stage, hockey stick graph. I'm curious to see how they pull another rabbit out of their hat on this one. Maybe raid a few more countries and steal their oil and gold. They've amazed me so far. It looks like a lot of folks are going to find out they're not in the club after all when this balloon of a market propped up by the Fed finally starts to come down. As if cash is going to be the savior, like more, not QE, is going to lessen the inflation. The banks are going to consume whatever's left, and they aren't going to make it easy for you to hide your wealth. Get ready for the final shakedown and stag, hyperinflation if this runaway train keeps on. Just like Berkshire has surpassed Apple and Google as the world's most prominent corporate cash holder. In Q3, Berkshire reported a record cash pile of $128 billion. How is it that Berkshire or their like won't be bailed in while a grandma with 500 bucks to her name is? Won't it be like Cyprus where those with the most owed to them by the banking system get the most substantial haircut? Concerning the pensions, 401k, IRA, their collapse would bring about a powerful deflationary impulse. My guess is that the solution would be some form of nationalization that would be modeled along the lines of Social Security. Again, haircuts would be progressive. Add to that inflation, and I'm guessing a plus 20 times reduction in the future purchasing power is what will happen. Those that saved wealth inside the system will have very little to show for it beyond their Social Security checks. I think the best way to preserve purchasing power and thus jump into the next monetary reality is to own, produce as much real stuff that you'll need to consume in the future and can store. After that, hold gold and silver to purchase things in the future, not comfortable or practical to store. Exchange real money for the new digital primarily domestic US dollar with interest rates back to positive margins over real inflation. We had a 20 times reduction in the purchasing power of debt via the higher interest rates, and real price increases from about 1972 to 1982. Stock PEs came back into alignment with reality, as well. The world didn't end then either, but real wealth was revealed, and life went on. Many economy watchers concede the decade-long, great manipulation we have witnessed will not work indefinitely, and eventually, markets will come crashing down around those in charge. With this in mind, it is easy to understand the allure of being one of those that will reap a fortune when it unravels. Years ago, President Eisenhower warned the American people about the industrial-military complex, but nobody warned us of an even more evil alliance than that of the financial-political complex. It would be wise to remember that those at the top control the game, and make the rules. In doing so, generous, they are not. There will undoubtedly be fireworks in 2022, and not to mention the huge pile of corporate debt which will be maturing in the next few years. Just because it hasn't hit doesn't mean the bullet isn't on its way. Only an idiot could look at the situation today and not see the end approaching. Greek debt is selling at a negative yield, for heaven's sake. And there's only one way this can end. The only question is how long the power that be can drag it out before it breaks. In the meantime, get your guns, grub, and gold. Bullets, beans, bandages, and bullion. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like. Share. Leave me a comment. Subscribe. And please take some time to subscribe to my backup channels, I do upload videos there too. You'll find the links in the description box. You will also find a PayPal link if you want to make a donation. Thank you wholeheartedly to all those of you who have already donated. Stay safe and healthy, friends.